How can I become Ram Swami? Nothing else can be done. Both ways. You need to do only one thing. You just need to understand there is nothing to be done. There is nothing to be achieved. The bliss is continuously happening in you. The bliss is continuously happening in you without the gap of time and space. We always have a problem. We are not ready to believe the bliss happens in us continuously without the gap of time and space. As long as you associate your bliss to a particular time or to a particular space, you will never have total bliss. You will continuously have only the suffering at few moments. The gap between the suffering, you may call it as a sukha. The gap between the suffering is only called as sukha. It can never be called as bliss. For example, the gap between two wars can never be called as the time of the peace. Or the peace time. 91 there was one war, 92 again one more war. You can't call the gap time, the interval period, as the time of peace. No. The interval time is just preparation for the next war. Same way, you can't call the time gap between two sufferings as bliss. No. In our life, what we experience is only the gap between two sufferings. The gap between two sufferings is what we call bliss. It can never be called as bliss. It is just sukha. Sukha can never be called as bliss. Sukha is just santosha. If you identify your bliss with some particular space, with some particular time, you can only have sukha at the most. Never the bliss. Only when you understand bliss continuously happens in you, you don't need some particular space or particular time to feel the ecstasy, to feel the bliss. Only then really the quantum bliss starts happening in you. For example, associating with a particular space. When I say the word space, I mean particular desires. For example, if you are continuously fantasizing about having a big home, the moment you make a big house and enter into that space, you feel blissful or you feel the sukha. You feel the happiness. Happiness associated with the space. Of course, house is also a space. The same way, particular object. If you want to be around that object, for example, car, only when you have the car around you, or you around that car, you feel the bliss. Same way, particular person, if you love somebody, if you feel that you should be around that person, again, you are bound. You are bound by that person. If that person is around you, you feel blissful. Otherwise, you feel disturbed. Again and again, you crave to be around that person, to be around that object, to be around that thing. As long as you associate your bliss with a particular space, you are bound by it. And one thing, you should be very clear. The moment your unconsciousness feels that you are bound by somebody, you start taking revenge. That is why all our relationship is love-hate relationship. You love somebody exactly the same intensity the other day you hate him. Exactly the same intensity. The more you love, the more will be the hatred. The more is hatred, more you will start loving. Because your unconsciousness takes revenge. You know you are dependent on him. Unless he is there, you will not be happy. You will not feel the bliss. When you are bound by somebody, you can never forgive him. You can never forgive that person. In a subtle way, you start possessing. Actually, possessiveness is nothing but taking revenge on the person. Be very clear, when you possess somebody, in a subtle way you take revenge. You just try to own him or own her. You can own an object, you can't own a living being. When you try to own somebody, you reduce him or her to an object. Energy becomes matter. You reduce the energy to a matter. When you try to possess, when you try to grab, when you try to keep him around you or under you, of course, trying to keep somebody around you is nothing but trying to keep them under you. Naturally, you take revenge. Whenever you love somebody, at the same moment you start hating. Love and hatred, both are just outcome of the same emotion, the same energy. The moment you feel you are having bliss from some space, naturally you start hating it. Because your unconscious knows you are becoming independent, you are becoming dependent. Your freedom is being taken away. Your freedom is slowly disappearing. You do not know any other technique. You do not know how to free yourself, how to liberate yourself from that particular person. You do not know how to liberate yourself from that particular desire. So naturally, you start taking revenge. You feel feeling of hatred. You feel that you are a slave. Whenever you associate your bliss with a particular space, be very clear, you became dependent, and not only you became dependent, surely today or tomorrow you will take revenge. Next thing, associating your bliss to a particular time. Again, if you were in a particular situation, in a particular time, if you have felt the bliss, you try your best to get the same experience again and again in your life. You try to bring that time again and again. You want the same time to repeat itself in your life. But you don't understand, when it repeats, you don't feel the same joy or the same ecstasy. Anything spontaneous creates bliss and joy. Anything formulated, regulated with the rules, regulation, law, naturally you find the things are lost, the juice, things are lost, the whole essence. As long as it is spontaneous, it is living, it is alive, it's like a real rose. When you don't want the rose to wither away, you bring plastic flower. Of course, plastic flowers, they never wither away. They are fresh, but they are never alive. They are never alive. When you try to bring the same time in your life, when you try, when you want the same thing, same time to repeat itself again and again in your life, naturally you feel sick. After a few times, again you feel the low mood, the low energy. As long as you associate your bliss with a particular space and a particular time, you continuously feel only the sickness and depression, never the life, never the bliss, never the energy. The moment you understand your bliss does not depend, it is no way related to the time and space, naturally you enter into a new space called quantum bliss. Naturally you experience a different space called quantum bliss. Naturally you experience a different time, which I call timeless zone or timeless energy. As long as you associate your bliss with the time and space, you will be only between suffering and happiness, at the most happiness, nothing more than that. But when you find the root of these two is one and the same experience, if you associate with the time and space, it leads to suffering. The same experience, if you associate with your inner experience, instead of connecting yourself with the time and space, it leads to bliss. Small example. Again and again you have a deep desire to eat some special sweet. When the desire arises, your mind just moves towards the sweet. At particular time, you get the sweet, you start eating. The moment you start enjoying the sweet, something happens in you. That is what you call as joy or happiness. If you associate that happiness with the sweet, naturally you will work towards getting the sweet again and again. We forget to understand one thing, a simple thing. If the joy is there in the sweet, again and again it should bring the same joy, but it is not. After fourth time or after fifth time, you feel bored. Sixth time, you say no. Seventh time, you say no, no more. You try to escape from the same sweet which gave you joy, which gave you bliss. Now you are trying to escape from the same seat, then something else must be the reason for your joy. If you see logically, it is not giving you joy anymore. Only the beginning it gives you joy. Later on, either today or tomorrow it says, no, I don't want, enough. Then something else must be the reason. Why you felt the joy, why you felt the bliss, let us analyze that. Actually, when you have a deep desire to enjoy something, the thoughts, number of thoughts in your mind increases. Continuously your mind is working towards that object. The moment the object is near you, the moment that object enters your space, the moment it is around you, naturally the number of thoughts, it comes down. The frequency rate comes down. The number of thoughts per minute, when it comes down, you feel the peace and the bliss which is continuously with you, within you. The bliss and the peace which is inside you expresses itself. When the peace and the bliss expresses itself, you feel the joy and the bliss inside your being. But without having a clarity, without having a clear wisdom, you try to associate that joy and that bliss with an object. Instead of associating the joy with the subject, you start associating with object. When you associate the joy with the object, you continue to search for more and more sweets, more and more enjoyment, and end up in diabetes. Nowhere else. If you start associating or if you start analyzing the root of the bliss subjectively, naturally you go deep inside and understand whenever the frequency of thought comes down, you feel the bliss. Whenever the frequency of thought comes down, you feel the bliss. That's a beautiful saying in the Yoga Sutra. You never experience joy or bliss because of something outside. When you enjoy, you breathe in a special way. Your flow of prana comes to a particular rhythm. It comes to a particular style. If the same style repeats itself at any point, you feel the same joy. And they say, technically, working on your prana, by working on your prana, you can bring the same rhythm, you can bring the same style of prana, the flow of energy, without the object. That is what they call pranayama. Mastering your energy flow, all our desires, all our bliss, all our so-called joy is nothing but a particular energy flow, a particular flow of prana, a particular way of prana movement. If you can bring the same flow of prana, even without that object, that same joy, same ecstasy can be felt. Next comes Pratyahara. The yoga says beautifully, a man who has mastered the technique of bringing back a particular breathing rhythm, a particular flow of prana, he doesn't need anything from the outer world. He is in the ecstasy. He is in the bliss. He is in the bliss continuously. There is no space associated with his bliss. He is liberated from the space. Liberated from the space means he is liberated from the five senses. He doesn't need anymore a particular space to be happy. He is free. Then comes next step. Dharana means if constantly, continuously, if he is able to maintain the same energy flow, same flow of prana inside him, if he is able to continuously have that joy, that ecstasy within himself, he is liberated from the time. So when you get into the particular energy flow, a flow of the prana, which creates tremendous joy and bliss in you, without associating itself with a particular space or a particular time, naturally you are liberated from so-called outwardly objects. You enter into a space called quantum bliss. Your bliss is neither restricted by a particular space nor restricted by particular time. This is the hypothesis I am proposing.